good job. It's your boy Ross back at again with another video. So you guys wanted me to check out Booked Episode 2, Roman Reigns versus The Rock by Superkick Studios. We're gonna check this out. This should be a good one. I wish this was gonna happen at WrestleMania, but from the reports, doesn't look like it's gonna happen at WrestleMania this year. This would be the ideal match for the type of reign that Roman Reigns has been having for the past, you know, year now. And it would be such a great moment to see Roman versus The Rock at WrestleMania. So I'm not sure if it's gonna happen. It doesn't look like it is, but we can still hope and dream that maybe it does. Appreciate all the love and support, man. Let's get right into this video.
Of Booked, the series where I put my creative hat on and we book a storyline or angle from the past or one that could be coming up in the future. In this one, it's all about the Bloodline. One of the most anticipated matches and the match that's on many wrestling fans' mind is Roman Reigns versus The Rock. Mm-hmm. The last true money match left in WWE.
This is the chance
for WWE to tell a personal story involving the biggest star in professional wrestling and one of the world's biggest global megastars. Without a doubt, when this match happens, all eyes will be on WWE. And more than likely, it will be Rock's final run in the wrestling business. Mm-hmm. Before I start off, I just wanted to reiterate,
I'm being honest with you. This happens, it would probably be The Rock's last wrestling match. And I think everyone would see this. Everyone would love to see this. This would be the biggest match they could ever do, bro.
That these bookings are simply just my own creativity talking. It's how I would do it if I had the chance. And this series, a lot of you guys have been asking, we're gonna keep it to one episode per month. So let's set the stage.
All right, see what he can do.
It's April 3rd, 2022. We're at the second day of WrestleMania 38. The main event match is Brock Lesnar, Drew McIntyre, and Roman.
Which a lot of people are predicting to be the main event of on the blue brand, for sure. A lot of people are predicting this.
Roman Reigns for the
Even though it kind of sucks because Roman versus The Rock, Roman versus Brock Lesnar is happening on WWE Day 1. So Brock gets three opportunities unless he wins the Royal Rumble. I don't know, bro.
Universal Championship. For weeks now, it's been teased that Paul Heyman has been working with Brock Lesnar, while animosity between Brock and Drew has carried over since the beginning of 2020. Mm-hmm. The three have a phenomenal match, and it looks like a car crash at ringside. The barricade is knocked down, the ring mats are ripped up, weapons everywhere, multiple tables have been broken through. But near the end stages of the match, Drew McIntyre has been neutralized on the outside, and it's Brock and Roman left in the ring. Paul Heyman gets into the ring with the Universal Championship. He delays for a second before slowly walking towards Brock Lesnar. He bends down on one knee and presents it to Brock Lesnar as the crowd lets out a collective gasp. Just as he's about to hand it over, Heyman hits Lesnar with a low blow, and Brock is caught by a spear from an oncoming Roman Reigns. Reigns makes the cover to retain the Universal Championship, extending his
reign. That would be interesting. I can see that. I can see them booking it like that, too. It's a triple threat match. Anything goes.
Into over 500 days. Heyman and Reigns are celebrating in the ring, and just as Heyman is about to raise Reigns' arm, we hear The Rock's theme song hit.
Bro, I ain't gonna lie to you. Me, Dub, Trillbilly, and the millions and millions of The Rock's fans would mark the fuck out if we hear his music. We mark out. Oh my God, that would be great.
The crowd at AT&T Stadium is going wild. Rock takes his sweet time getting to the ring, soaking up the reaction from the crowd. Roman is in the ring with a big smile on his face. Rock grabs a microphone and says, I was in town and I just wanted to stop by, say hi to the 80,000 here at AT&T Stadium. And then he looks at Roman. He says, you have been operating on a completely different level. I just came here to say congratulations on all that you've achieved. You've truly made our bloodline proud. He goes to raise Reigns' hand, but Reigns snatches his arm away from The Rock. He instead extends his arm out for a hug while he's smiling ear to ear. The two share a tight hug, and Reigns' smiling face slowly turns to a snarl. He transitions that hug into a rock bottom, planting The Rock. Reigns is on top of Rock, screaming out, "You want to come ruin my moment?"
That would be good. That would be great. Oh, that would be great. Oh, this is better than anything WWE has booked, damn near. Jesus Christ, in the past year alone, that would be cool.
"You want to take my shine away? This is my industry. This is my company. This is my bloodline. I am the one." Rock lays prone in the ring, and WrestleMania 38 goes off the air with Reigns raising the Universal Championship with pyro blaring everywhere, and his foot is on top of Rock's prone body. News outlets everywhere are reporting about The Rock's return. Mm-hmm. There's a huge buzz for outsiders on who this Roman Reigns guy is.
Yep.
People are clued in that there's a match coming up, and the buzz is at an absolute fever pitch. Mm-hmm. It's a SmackDown after WrestleMania 38. Reigns is ready to cut a promo in the ring, and all he hears before he starts talking is chants of Rocky. Yep. Reigns says that he sent him packing back to Hollywood. He's not here. He's gone. This is my show, and it's time to acknowledge the tribal chief. Yep. A chorus of boos fills the arena before...
You're still making him a great heel. That's... You don't need to change him. You don't need to change him. It still works. I love this, keeping him a heel.
Before we hear Kurt Angle's theme song hit. Kurt's at the top of the ramp, and he says that WWE called him personally to manage someone, and that he'd like Roman to meet who he believes is the future of the company, his protege, Gable Steveson. Steveson squares up to Reigns in the ring. Reigns shrugs him off like it's nothing, and he leaves. Over the coming few months, Gable Steveson tears through opponents like it's nothing, displaying a natural athleticism and understanding for the professional wrestling business. This includes wins against the best on SmackDown, and also a King of the Ring win,
okay, new
which
talent.
He can use to challenge the champion of his choosing. But for Reigns, on the other hand, his bloodline is growing. Naomi has joined after being fed up with Sonya Deville, and they introduce one final member to the stable, Solo Sikoa from NXT.
I know a lot of y'all have been actually telling me this. A lot of y'all have been telling me this, that they have, the Usos have a brother in NXT. I guess this is who y'all talking about. I can see this. This makes sense. And, of course, adding Naomi into the mix. I know a lot of y'all been suggesting that. I didn't know how that would work, but it kind of makes sense. So, you know, with her feud with management. So, okay. I'm buying into it.
He shows his allegiance to Reigns, and he tells them that he truly is the best in the family. He says he had a smile on his face when Reigns planted The Rock at WrestleMania. But the fans, they know that something's up. They can tell that Solo is up to no good. Over the coming months, the bloodline goes on an even bigger power trip on SmackDown. Mm-hmm. Naomi is the women's champion. The Usos are the tag team champions. Solo Sikoa is the IC champion. And of course, Roman Reigns is the...
That would be cool. Everyone family related, bloodline. Hey, champs. Everybody's champ. I like that, man.
The longest reigning Universal Champion of all time. After WrestleMania, WWE has a superstar shakeup, and coming to SmackDown is former WWE Champion Big E alongside Randy Orton. After WrestleMania 38, Roman's first big feud is Big E. Mm-hmm. The simple premise of proving that Big E is the one that can beat Roman Reigns. Big E calls on Xavier and Kofi to help neutralize the others in the bloodline. By SummerSlam 2022, this feud has been white hot. It's not even about titles anymore. The Bloodline and the New Day have been carrying SmackDown, putting on the best matches, but still, the New Day keeps coming up short against Reigns' Bloodline because they have that extra member. So the main event at SummerSlam is a War Games match between three members of the Bloodline and the New Day.
That would be cool too, incorporating War Games into the main roster. Sign me up.
Simply to prove who the better team is and who truly runs SmackDown. In that match, Solo Sikoa is not in it, but he tries to enter the cage, but instead he causes a distraction, leading to the Bloodline losing. They do keep all their titles, however. After SummerSlam, tension is getting heated between Reigns and Solo. Reigns is pissed at Solo and he says, "Before you got here, things were going so much better. We were untouchable." He looks down at him and he says, "Walk. Walk. You're the reason that I was embarrassed. You are the reason why I didn't walk out of SummerSlam with the win. Losing is not accepted in this family." Reigns says to the Usos, "Do your worst," as he walks away. Solo Sikoa is beaten down and kicked out of the Bloodline. He's written off with an injury and his championship is subsequently vacated.
Like that as well. This is really good, bro. He's doing a good job of really creating this Bloodline faction and increasing it, creating some dissension. I like this. I'm liking this a lot.
Reigns turns his eye to a feud with Randy Orton, facing him at Extreme Rules 2022, and he retains the Universal title again. He just keeps adding more and more impressive names to this legendary title run. Everyone from Cena, Edge, Lesnar, Orton, it just keeps on growing. Mm-hmm. At Survivor Series 2022, it's the 10-year anniversary of The Shield, and the main event of that show is WWE Champion Seth Rollins versus Universal Champion Roman Reigns. They have a phenomenal match going back and forth. They're laying out all the hits, but at the end, it's Reigns who stands tall. He's later confronted at the end of the show by Gable Steveson and Kurt Angle. Steveson has won the King of the Ring and he's been dismantling opponents for the past 8 months. He makes it clear that he wants to face Reigns at the Royal Rumble for the Universal Championship. Over the coming while leading up to the Rumble, Steveson is fed competitors left, right, and center, which he goes through with ease. Those competitors include the Usos. The Usos can't beat Steveson, and Roman's laughing at him like, "You can't beat a rookie," and now there's even more signs of cracks in the blood.
A lot. This is how you get new talent over. Someone that is legitimate, following the footsteps of Kurt Angle, you get him over like this. You book him strong. That's how you get him over. I don't trust WWE to do this, but I like what he's coming up with. This is really enjoyable. Him and what's his name? Adam. They're both, it's like their creative minds destroy anything that Vince, Bruce, and the people they have in creative could ever produce. And they're doing it on YouTube. It's like an easy blueprint. They could easily take this if they wanted to. Maybe switch it up a bit. Like, I don't know, man.
Bloodline. Reigns holds a Bloodline meeting in the back and he says that either win or you're out. Things are starting to escalate between the Usos and Reigns, and they're getting in each other's face. We're at the Royal Rumble, and in the middle of the show, it's a Universal Championship match, Gable Steveson versus Roman Reigns. Steveson takes it to Reigns, but Reigns has the upper hand. There's a spot where the ref is knocked down, and the Usos come out to help Reigns. But they end up kicking Reigns in the face by accident. The Usos are chased off by the New Day, and Reigns is on his feet. He's going for a spear, just as we hear.
Bro, crowd loses their shit. Holy fuck. Once again, oh man, and that's perfect. Just keep the Rock away. Keep the Rock away. People will tend to, they'll have it in the back of their heads. They'll probably think, oh, maybe next year at WrestleMania. Just keep the Rock away. Oh, that would be great.
The Rock returns standing at the top of the ramp. This is enough to distract Roman Reigns. He turns towards Steveson and he's hit by multiple angle slams. An ankle lock ends it. Roman Reigns, for the first time in his career, taps out, loses the Universal Championship, and a brand new star is made.
Holy shit. I don't know why I'm getting excited for that. Would be cool. I know some people would disagree, but you gotta find the next star, and you're doing it right there. That makes him a star. That makes him the top of the top guy, bro. He beat Roman Reigns and made him tap. Oh my God. Oh, that would be, you have your star right there.
In Gable Steveson. He's the one who beat the unbeatable. Not just that, but he tapped him out.
And he's legitimate. He's legitimate. It's not no BS. He can really go. That's cool.
With this victory, you've taken the Universal title off Roman Reigns, and you've built a brand new top star in the WWE.
Thank you.
The night isn't over yet, though. Rock makes his way down to the ring, and as Reigns is slowly getting up, he hits him with a rock bottom.
Yes.
And as The Rock stands over top of him, he says, "Your table is the one that I made."
That gave me goosebumps. That would be so cool. Your table is the one that I made, motherfucker. Oh, that's good. Without me, there is no bloodline for you. I love
Rock
it.
Rock looks over at the WrestleMania 39 sign. Then he looks down at Reigns and he just says to him, "We're going Hollywood, bitch." He gets on the ring rope and the stage is set.
Yeah.
The next SmackDown, Reigns is in a rage, trashing everyone in the locker room, every object
yes.
he comes near, and anything in his path.
Yes.
He kicks off the show in the ring, calling The Rock out. He says, "You want to steal my moments from me? You want to tarnish everything that I worked so hard to create? It eats you up inside that I have eclipsed you. I've overshadowed your legacy." He tells him to get to the ring. He says, "Rock just wants him at Mania so that he can be famous again. But Roman Reigns, he's not here to make people famous." Vince McMahon then comes out to confront Roman and he says that Rock's not here. Roman says to Vince, "For the sake of your roster, he better be here next week." Vince signals for security to escort Reigns out of the building because having him around just isn't safe. The next week, Reigns opens up the show again and he's like, "Dwayne, get yourself out here." But Rock doesn't show up. Instead, it's Rikishi. Rikishi shows up and he tries to talk some sense into Roman. He says, you've gotten out of hand. If you didn't do what you did at last year's WrestleMania, we wouldn't be in this position." Rikishi asks, "What's this whole thing about? We're a family." Reigns says, "Family? This was never about family." He lays his hand on Rikishi saying, "Where is he?" He twists his collar, getting more and more impatient. Reigns slowly clenches up on the top of Rikishi's shirt, getting closer and closer to him. The Usos come out and break Reigns away from their father, Rikishi. In a backstage segment, the Usos and Rikishi are sitting in their locker room, and Rikishi reminds them that they were just fine before they started to tag along with Reigns. He says that this man is supposed to be your family, but he uses you at every turn imaginable.
I love this. So this would be the best storyline in WWE we've had in quite some time, and it's been booked for over 2 years. That's, oh man. Somebody hire this guy, hire Adam. Can we get some people from the YouTube community jobs at WWE Creative? Please, man.
Imaginable. "Jimmy, do you remember when he choked you out and your brother had to quit? He doesn't care about you. This isn't about family, it's about him." Rikishi gets up and he leaves the Usos in the room. The two look at each other and then they just hang their heads, conflicted at what to do. The next week, Rock appears via pre-taped video message. He says to Roman, "Let's see who really runs this family. You want to come out here pretending that you're the head of some table that doesn't exist? If not for the foundation that others laid before you, you're not the head of any table, you're just wiping tables.
Whoop!
You want to
That's a good line. That's a good line.
Who really runs this family, it will be my pleasure to shut you up in Los Angeles. You don't want to make people famous, well, neither do I. But I will make you my bitch." At the end of that night's SmackDown, Reigns makes his way down to the ring. And he's mellowed down a little bit. He says, "The Rock, he's not here to acknowledge me, but I found someone who will. Bring her out," he says. Naomi then walks out with The Rock's daughter, Simone, in hand. Reigns says, "What's your name?" She says, "Simone. Simone Johnson, right? The Rock's daughter. Yes."
Oh, wow. This is really ramped. This is, bro, whoa. Okay. This is taking a whole new approach.
"And where exactly is your dad right now? He's at some movie premiere, hanging out in the hills with his little movie friends, isn't he?" Reigns is getting more and more vicious towards Simone. "While I'm here carrying this company, he's playing games. Let me tell you, there is nothing fake about this. This goes back years. Years to when I first started, and everyone says that I was only here because of my name. Because I am The Rock's cousin. He turns his attention towards Simone again. He's screaming in her face, where is he? Why isn't he here? Why is he trying to tear down everything that I
this
built?
Is getting
I
real
am
personal.
This family. I am the star. I am the WWE. I am the Anoa'i family. Without me, this company is done. So, Simone, the reason why you are here is you will acknowledge me. He starts to scream, acknowledge me, in her face. This segment is beyond uncomfortable.
Yeah.
Simone shrivels her body inwards because she's that uncomfortable. She starts bawling her eyes out, and Reigns just laughs. Reigns says, theatrics? What'd you learn that from your dad? Nice try. I'm gonna give you one more opportunity to do what your father doesn't, and that is to say that I'm the-
That is such... When you start getting families involved, that's when shit get personal. Having The Rock's daughter out there, oh, that gets personal. I love this.
The top of the food chain, and acknowledge me. Simone refuses to do this, and she's just completely a mess. Her makeup is everywhere, and then Reigns just tips his head towards Naomi. Naomi lays out Simone. The show goes off the air with Roman Reigns kneeled down over top of Rock's daughter with the biggest smile on his face. He looks into the camera and he says, you see what I'm cooking? Things have gotten very personal between The Rock and Reigns. The Usos at this point lose the tag team championships, and there's an inner war starting to brew among the bloodline. The Usos go into Reigns' locker room and they said that no matter what our pop told us, we still stand with you. You're the one. The next SmackDown, Rock is announced for the show. In the middle of the show, we get an irate Rock talking about how Reigns did this to himself. He acted as though he created something from scratch, even though it was him who started with $7 in his pocket and changed everything. The night ends with Rock in the ring. He's having fun with the crowd, he's throwing out his one-liners, but he says it's time to get down to business. Roman Reigns, get your ass out here. Reigns comes out with the Usos, dragging slightly behind him. Reigns gets into the ring while the Usos stay outside. Vince McMahon has made it evident that these two men cannot touch each other. This is a big money match. And
I like that. I love this. It gives me, if you guys remember, when Triple H and Stone Cold wanted to get each other's hands on each other, but they couldn't, or they were going to lose out on opportunities at WrestleMania. I like this. You cannot touch each other. If you do, the match is off. I love this. It builds that tension of the crowd wanting this to happen. So they have to go other ways to get personal. I love this.
And he's not risking anyone getting injured. Rock talks to Roman and he says, let me give you a dose of reality. You, with all your gifts, with the amount of time this company has invested in you, with your look, your size, you want to come out here and call yourself the head of the table. By doing that, you're disrespecting our ancestors, the trailblazers who came before you. Peter Maivia, Rocky Johnson, Afa, Sika, Rikishi. Reign says he, quite frankly, doesn't care. All of those people didn't make him, he made them. Roman says, you're in Hollywood leeching over my name. Everyone's always talking about how it's The Rock, it's The Rock. I'm gonna end The Rock. How about if I beat you, you leave this all behind? But if you beat me, I will acknowledge you as the head of the table, and more importantly, the best in this family. Reigns then signals to the Usos to get in the ring. They get in the ring and they stand face to face with The Rock. Jimmy looks at Jay and they just think of what they're about to do. Right as they buck up, Rikishi's theme song plays. He says, Usos, no, don't touch him. Reigns is yelling at the Usos to attack The Rock, and Rikishi's saying, no, don't do it, that is your family. And it becomes a screaming match between Rikishi and Roman. Slowly, the Usos have a disgusted look on their face, and they look like they're about to attack The Rock. But they look at their dad Rikishi, and they leave Roman Reigns alone with The Rock. Reigns is in a rage that the Usos aren't following his orders. The next week on SmackDown, Reigns is holding what's called the Tribal Chiefs Forum. Reigns walks down to the ring and he's got an old album in his hand. He welcomes everyone and he says, "Here we're gonna celebrate The Rock's career one final time." He talks about the Hollywood run, the matches with Austin. He talks about how The Rock has become such a global phenomenon, but he says that global phenomenon won't be seen anymore. He's gonna render him so useless, he won't even be able to do movies anymore. No, screw that. He won't even be able to hug his wife and children. He then gets the album. In it are moments with him and The Rock from when they were younger. There's moments of Roman backstage as a kid. There's pictures of their families together. He shows this off to everyone.
It's really good. Combining realism with a storyline makes this so much more entertaining.
And then he says, "Wise man, bring it in." Paul Heyman brings in a trash can and Reigns lights the album on fire with a disgusted look on his face. And he says, "I'm the one. Then, now, forever."
He
drops the album into the can as SmackDown goes off the air. Throughout this whole feud, the video packages are some of the best WWE has ever produced. Mm-hmm. They talk about just how big of a match this is. They parallel both Roman Reigns and Rock's path to the top. They also have superstars from different eras talking about how big and how personal this match.
This match would literally be one of the biggest matches WWE has ever, I mean ever, produced. I'm dead ass. Dead ass. If this happens and they book it right, this would be one of the greatest matches we will ever see in WrestleMania history. Especially the way he's booking this right now.
Matches, how deep this feud truly goes, and it adds a ton of value to an already hyped up match. It's the final SmackDown before WrestleMania 39.
Woo!
Reigns and Rock are set to have one final face-to-face. In that segment, Reigns and Rock are on separate sides with security in the center separating them both. The entire Samoan family is lined up at the top of the ramp. Rikishi, the Wild Samoans, the Usos, and so many others. Both men are trading barbs back and forth and the shirts are coming off. They're ready to do this thing right here, right now. Reigns has one last line and he says to The Rock, "This was truly never about family. This was and always will be about me. The best. My legacy. The one." You know what? Umaga's gone. Your father, Rocky Johnson, he's dead too. And on Sunday, you'll be joining them in hell.
Oh my God. Oh, I wish. Oh my God. They went that road. I'm done. Oh man.
This line draws a crazy reaction from the crowd. They are booing Reigns to oblivion and The Rock has lost it. He's completely set off. But there's just so much security that he's held back and he can't do anything. Reigns is on his way up to the ramp, just laughing his ass off at what he says. He then walks by the Anoa'i family, and he just laughs at them. Just as he's about to go to the back, he turns back for a second and he squares up to Rikishi. He headbutts him, he laughs, and he says, "I did it for The Rock."
Oh my God, no!
Rikishi bleeds from the head. Reigns takes his hand, wipes off Rikishi's blood onto his hand, and he wipes it over his chest with a smile on his face while The Rock can't do anything. This feud has gotten so personal, and now it's time.
It's time. Woo! This is such innocent
it's
Hollywood.
WrestleMania 39, LA. Los Angeles, California, Hollywood. WrestleMania 2023 is only one night.
Thank
it's
God.
Headlined by the family feud, no championships, no gimmicks, a one-on-one match, the legacy versus the career. In a backstage segment, the Usos go into Reigns' locker room and they say, "We're out. You attacked our dad. We can't ride with you no more. You're on your own." Reigns is left in his locker room and he's just pissed off at what has happened. But now, it's time. The Rock makes his final entrance to a thunderous pop. The Rock is wearing a lei, and the entranceway is made to look like an island. There's Samoan props, there's torches, there's a makeshift fire, and it's a respect to Rock's heritage. Rock hangs the lei on the ring post after his entrance. Now it's time for Reigns to come out. Reigns' choir sings, but this time the songs slow down and very sinister. Roman Reigns is rising up through the stage as he sits on a huge throne. There's a fire around the area where the throne is slowly rising up, and slowly we see him sitting like he's the king of the world. Mm-hmm. He's got a crown on and he's wearing a lei. You guys know how Undertaker had those hands trying to grab him in one of his entrances? Well, for Reigns, there's people around the throne literally bowing at his feet. The island theme from The Rock's entrance makes the visual all the more stunning. Just as Reigns is about to get up from the throne, he rips the lei in half, signaling everything that he has become. He has no respect for the past or his family. This is all about him. He's made it so personal because he wants all the attention. He is the biggest star in professional wrestling. He walks down the steps of the throne and to the ring, and he's just laughing at all the Samoan props. He's got his game face on as fire blares around him.
Mm.
And now it's time. The bell rings and these two start off brawling. Yep. No headlocks, chain wrestling.
Nope.
These guys are trying to destroy each other after not being able to get their hands on one another.
That's all you want to see.
But slowly, Reigns gets the upper hand and transitions the pace of the match to slow and methodical.
Mm-hmm.
Reigns goes for a spear early, but Rock counters. They brawl onto the outside. Rock hits him with a rock bottom onto the announce table. There's finishers left, right, and center, but still nothing. Rock then hits a people's elbow, and he's going for a rock bottom. He hits the rock bottom, but he takes the referee out in the process.
Sounds about right.
Reigns hits Rock with a low blow,
of course,
and he's laughing at him, just pacing around, saying, "My industry, my company, my legacy, my WWE. Just as he's getting in the corner, ready for a spear, the crowd erupts. Roman's father is on the entrance ramp, and Reigns looks at him, and he just falls down. All the emotions are starting to come back to him. He says, "What have I become?" He looks over at The Rock, and he says, "We were family." And he's just slapping himself in the face and saying, "What have I become? What have I become?" He starts to shed a tear, and his head is down. The camera zooms in, and then his head comes up. He just laughs at the camera, and he tells everyone, "You were going to fall for that again?"
I know. Oh, my God. He did it before Hell in a Cell. That's good. He would be the most mega heel of all time.
Exactly who I am.
I love it.
Gets up, hits Rock with a spear. Reigns gets back to his feet, but he doesn't go for the pin. He hits Rock with another spear. Reigns gets up and he says, "You did this. Now it's time for me to be acknowledged. I am this industry. I am the one. Enjoy being famous." Reigns goes for a third and definitive spear, and he gets the 1-2-3. The match is now over.
I was not expecting that. I was expecting The Rock to win this. You have just made him. He's immortalized. Oh, my God. That is fantastic. I was expecting The Rock to win this, but wow, this is awesome.
The Rock is completely beaten down, and everyone knows this is it for The Rock. Everyone's chanting, "Thank you, Rocky." But up at the top are more members of the Anoa'i family. They've all joined Roman's father, Sika. They all look at Rock with a neutral look, and they signal to him that you know what to do. Rock grabs the lei he wore to the ring, and he says, "I acknowledge you." Places the lei over Reigns' neck, and symbolically, the legacy has been passed down. The final match for The Rock is one of his best matches ever. They go balls to the wall. This feud has been amazing. And Reigns becomes an even bigger star.
Yeah.
The show ends with pyro blaring and the whole world acknowledging Roman Reigns. He truly is the one.
That's beautiful. That's great, actually. That's actually fucking great. Holy. Yo, that's fantastic.
Quickly, I'm going to give you guys my thought process behind what I did. First of all, I made Roman Reigns an even bigger heel. He's always talked about how he's doing everything for the family and not for him. Well, here, it's all about him.
And that's good, because now he doesn't have the gold around his waist. So now it changes. It's not about the family no more. It's about me. It's only about me. It's always been about me. You can see it's really all about him. It's not about family, but he spins it that way. As long as they keep helping him, that's all that matters.
It's a 180 from his current character, and slowly his true intentions come out. He disrespects everything that he was once praising. From the moment he came back at the Thunderdome, he knew exactly what he was doing. He was using his so-called family to get and stay at the top. With making the Bloodline go on an absolute power trip, I've built them up as a solid stable, introduced a new star in Solo Sikoa. I've also torn the Bloodline apart, because after this match, you could tell the story of the civil war going on between the Bloodline. Mm-hmm. With that, I've introduced audiences to Simone Johnson, who's training at the WWE Performance Center. At the same time, I've taken the title off Roman Reigns and given a huge rub to Gable Steveson. I've added a few more big names to this legendary title run, a match with Orton, Rollins, and a couple extra months for Reigns to truly make this a legendary run. Now you have different directions to pivot, more stories to tell, more stars on your roster. Reigns can go back to chasing the Universal title or even moving brands. And the match has elevated Reigns even further. And the best part is I didn't have to use a stupid golden egg.
Thank you. Thank you. He literally just did this with just the creative talent that's on the roster, creating new stars, no extra gimmicks behind it.
So there it is. I hope you guys enjoyed this one. I know it's a little long, but hey, I was gonna put in work on these rather than...
Yo, this was fantastic. This was easily one of the best bookings I have seen in quite some time. I enjoyed this. I was visualizing all the stuff he was describing. This was fantastic. This was great. I love this. I love this, man. I love it. I like this. You create a bigger heel in Roman. You let it get personal. You create new stars. Perfect, man. Sign me up. Sign me up. We may not get The Rock and Roman at this year's WrestleMania, which I don't think is going to happen. But if we can get him at next year's and they build it right, that means he needs to lose the title, obviously. Because if he doesn't lose the title, the booking kind of looks a little bit too obvious, only because The Rock's not about to be the Universal Champion. So at some point, he would have to lose that belt. And that means they have to have someone that is a big star or whatnot. So, yeah, man, I appreciate all the love and support on the channel, man. Thank you to everyone that sent me this video to watch this. This was enjoyable. I hope you guys enjoyed this, because I definitely did. And comment down below. Let me know, did you guys enjoy his booking of this? Because I did. This was great, fantastic. And I'm looking forward to checking out some more of his content. And appreciate all the love and support. Roll to 70K. Appreciate y'all kicking with me. See y'all on the next one. Peace.